Thank you. Happy Easter. Felices Pascuas. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. As we continue our journey of Easter, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which once we renounce Satan and his works and the promise to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? May the Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace for eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away."
Thanks be to God.
Just God. world.
The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, "I know him," but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified, and though they had that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do you questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost doesn't have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." As he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it, ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ should suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Please have a seat, and if you still have your ticket number 148, please give it to me now. Los que aún tienen su boleto de misa número 148, tráiganme el boleto, por favor. Muchas gracias. Thank you very much. Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much. Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias. Thank you much. Okay. Happy Easter. Felices Pascuas. In the readings of today, we hear two different themes. One is that we can condense them into one, that is of witnessing. Las lecturas que nosotros tenemos este fin de semana, especialmente la primera lectura y el Evangelio, nos hablan del testimonio, de testificar. Y uno solamente puede testificar aquello que conoce, ¿verdad? Si usted le dice testifique algo que no conoce, usted dice, no, yo no puedo hacer eso porque no lo conozco, no sé de qué me habla. Solamente podemos testificar aquello que conocemos. Si no lo conoce, hágase a un lado. ¿Por qué? Porque se va a meter en problemas, ¿verdad? Y entonces es testimoniar, reconociendo que nuestro testimonio es el mismo, pero lo vamos entendiendo de una manera más profunda conforme va pasando el tiempo, ¿verdad? Cuando ya tienen muchas canas, como algunos de nosotros que tenemos canas y algunos no tienen ni pelo, ¿verdad? Ahí es donde vamos aprendiendo qué es lo que es el testimonio, ¿verdad? El testimonio es algo que es el mismo, pero lo vamos entendiendo de una manera más profunda, losers, profunda, de una manera más profunda, ¿verdad? So witnessing has this thing that even though our encounter with the Lord may be exactly the same thing, we will understand it in a different way. And the more we visit it, and the older we grow, and the gray hair that we get to acquire over the period of the years, then it just goes deepening and deepening and deepening. And it is the same thing, but we didn't understand it fully when it happened. It happened that when I was 18, I got baptized in the Catholic Church. I have shared this with you. I was 18, I got baptized, and I thought, I have understood everything that they taught me in the classroom. But an 18-year-old can understand just so much, right? Then I went to the seminary, and I thought I knew a lot of things. When we are in the seminary, a lot of times we think that we know everything more and even way better than our teachers, the priests that have been studying there for years, if not decades. In fact, for some of you that are from the 1960s or even 70s, even the 80s, you might remember a movie in which it was a movie for youngsters. And in the movie, there is this guy that portrays like the essence of freedom. And at some point, he's just so sick of his professor, a Harvard professor. And then he steps on the desk and he starts speaking to his classmates, basically telling them, you know, what he's saying, what the professor is saying, is just nonsense. Don't pay attention to him. So guess what? When I was in the seminary at some point, they were teaching us Latin, and I didn't like Latin because the Galatians were so hard for me. They were teaching us things that were hard for me to understand, and guess what I did? When our professor, one of the priests, stood out of the classroom because he had a phone call. This is before cell phones, okay? So this is in the 1980s. I stepped on his desk, and I started teaching my classmates, don't pay attention to him, because everything he's saying, you know, he's saying is nonsense and things like that. And I was in the seminary, right? Sometimes I wonder why they didn't just get rid of me and send me back home. Thank God they didn't do it, otherwise I would not be here, right? But what I am saying with this is that the things that in the past I used to dislike or have no reverence for or not care about, those are now the things that I care about the most. The things that were not important in the past, they are now becoming important in my present, and I hope that in my future as well. What I am saying is that it takes time to develop that witnessing that Christ is calling us to do. For instance, you are now sitting in that pew after, I don't know how many hours, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 hours of a whole day. You're thinking of the friends that you had to give up on, the events and the activities, the parks that you didn't go visit, all of the activities that you could have gone with your could have done with your friends, but you didn't do these things. Those things are important to you. And church may or may not be that important, right? It is important because you are here, but the level of importance will vary according to the person. And I hope but I hope it doesn't happen here, but it happens very frequently that we sometimes, when we are that age, we are in places just because my mom told me to. Not because I really want to be there, but because I was told to go, right? Well, guess what? The Lord is so patient with us that he is waiting for us a lifetime so that whatever is not important for us today, over a period of time, sometimes it takes a couple of months, most times it takes years, and even sometimes it takes decades to understand what the Lord gave me and what he is wanting me to do with it. I'm not expecting you to jump on your catechism class, on your classroom's desk, and start telling your classmates that what your professor, what your catechist is telling you is nonsense. I'm not expecting you to do that. But guess what? If it happens, I would not be surprised. And I'm not telling you to do it. I'm just saying that when we are that age, we do crazy things, don't we? Thank God I'm not that age anymore. I'm way about 3 and 3.5 decades after you, well, actually before you. So that's why I'm so old. But what I'm saying with this is that what you are being taught today, the experiences that you have, the liturgies that you celebrate, the chant that you sing or that you chant, the music, the songs that you have to sing, all of these things that you have to do today when you are older, there are things that you don't have to do, but they become things that you want to do because they are important for you. Amen? This is what I am saying. You're going to be confirmed very soon, is that right? You're going to be confirmed very soon. You have a sponsor that hopefully is a person that practices his or her faith. You have a sponsor that can help you with regards to your Christian life. When you do not understand something, you can always go back to this person and ask, what does it mean, this or that? Why do we have to, or why this or else? Hopefully you have a strong sponsor, a person that practices his or her faith and that is willing to deepen his or her faith, not because of you, but because of they themselves. This person is ready to help you to walk the journey of Christian life with you, because our Christian life is not an easy thing. There are some choices that you have to make in life, right? There's some things that you just have to do. And most times you're going to feel alone, even though you always count with the help of God. We always say that. You count with God's help, but we sometimes don't feel it. Well, guess what? Your sponsor is that person that will show that presence of God to you constantly. That sponsor of yours is that person that will help you keep up with things even when it is hard. And there's certain things in faith when there is no other way to understand them. For instance, who understands death? Who understands tragedy? Who understands war, famine, and all these things, violence, all these things that are going on in the world? We don't understand these things, and yet the sponsor is that person that walks with us every step of the Christian way so that we may enhance our faith, and in doing so, deepening into our witnessing, because at some point, you and I, boy, we all are going to have to do something with whatever we have been given. What we have been given is called a gift. What we do with that gift is called testimony. So when we receive a gift, we ponder it. Sometimes it takes a couple of months or a couple of years. Sometimes it takes many years, decades, right? However long it takes you, what you have been given is a gift. You have to transform it into a testimony so that people around you know of Christ because of how you live out your lives. Amen? In the gospel, in the first reading of today, the Acts of the Apostles, we see how the apostles are ready to give up their lives for Christ. And that is great, except that it took them months, years, and even decades to understand that. What we hear from the apostles is from a document that was written about the year 85 after, in the first century. Christ lived between, more or less, between year 1 until the year 33, 34, or 35, more or less. And what we hear the apostles doing is way later, about 50 years later. Not that the apostles did it 50 years later, but what we hear is the account of what they did over a period of years, and it was written about 50 years after Christ died and rose from the dead. Does that make sense? No, it doesn't. It doesn't. That's why I'm telling you this. It doesn't make sense, but it makes sense in the faith. Christ always waits for us. He gives us a gift, and he is expecting us, each and all, to transform this gift into a testimony so that we may speak of Christ by the way we live out our lives, maybe tomorrow, next week. For some of you, it's going to be next month or within a couple of years. And I hope that it is not true, but it happens all the time that for some of you, it's going to take decades before you really let that message sit, that gift sit, and then transform it into a testimony. I am saying this. Don't give up just because you don't understand today. Don't give up. Don't give up on Christ. Don't give up on his church. That's the most beautiful thing that we have in the world. When you step out of these walls, out of this room, there is a lot of things going on that we don't want to, sometimes we don't want to know about these things, but they are happening. This is our safe space. This is a space where we celebrate our faith. This is the space where we celebrate that Christ is alive, that he has given us a gift, and the place where we celebrate that this gift needs to be transformed into a testimony. In order to make that gift a testimony, we need time. We need time. Sometimes it'll take a few months or a few years. Sometimes it'll take many years and even decades. But we never give up on Christ, because Christ never, ever gives up on us. Happy Easter! Felices Pascuas. Since we have already professed our faith at the beginning of Mass, let us continue with the prayers of the faithful.
Let us pray for the church, for ourselves, that we may be witnesses to the risen Lord, revealing his presence in our acts of mercy and love, and bringing his healing touch to those in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those who are in authority, that they may pursue justice, right the wrongs that persist, and lift up those who are opposed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those who are ill, in prison, homeless, or neglected, that they and those who care for them may recognize the Lord in each other. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our donors, ministries, families, children, the elderly, and the unemployed, that the Lord will see to their every need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer. We pray for our confirmation candidates, for their sponsors. De una manera especial también rogamos por sus papás que los apoyen en la transmisión de la fe. Que el Señor les conceda a ustedes ser agentes del amor de Dios en sus vidas. Let us pray to the Lord. We also pray for our intentions and the intentions of about 30 families that celebrate this Mass with us online, especially for the sick, for those who are traveling, for those who are in the hospital and homebound, that God may give them his peace and his Easter joy. Let us pray to the Lord. At this time, I would like all of us to pray for these young men and women, that God may grant them a vocation very, very soon. Let us pray for vocations. Jesus, our Savior, your Sacred Heart felt compassion when you looked upon the crowd and saw that they were like sheep without a shepherd. We know that the harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So we ask you, the Master of the harvest, to send out more laborers. Open my heart and the hearts of my brothers and sisters to your will. Raise up joyful young men and women
who are open to grow in holiness and devotion and spend themselves for your people in the Diocese of Austin as nuns, sisters, monks, brothers, friars, permanent deacons and priests. May no one in your flock, one at the price of your blood, be without a shepherd to guide them. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now take a moment to prepare our offerings. Father Almighty, we give you thanks during this Easter season for the many blessings that you give us, especially the blessing of the resurrection of Christ Jesus, your Son and our Lord. As we walk down the aisle to the altar, please receive from our hands and from our hearts everything that we bring to you today. Receive it through Christ our Lord. Father, we thank you for the blessings that you give us, especially the blessing of health and the blessing of our family and this Christian family. We ask you today that you please receive these offerings that your Holy Church presented today. Receive them through Christ our Lord. Hermanas y hermanos, para que nuestro sacrificio sea agradable a Dios Padre Todopoderoso. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. El Señor esté con ustedes. Levantemos el corazón. Demos gracias al Señor nuestro Dios. It is really right and just our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through Christ, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving you thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with Joe, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and the sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
If you cannot receive Holy Communion today, please say this prayer with me. My Jesus, I believe that you're present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray.
Look with kindness upon your holy people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Hola amigos y amigas, mi nombre es Catherine Angulo, soy la directora del programa Thriving in Ministry Initiatives en el Instituto McGrath de la Universidad de Notre Dame y de verdad que es un honor muy grande para mí el ser una de las oradoras que van a tener ustedes en esta conferencia de la mujer el sábado 20 de abril en su parroquia, en donde vamos a estar hablando de la belleza del papel de la mujer en traer esta cultura eucarística entre nuestras realidades de la familia, desde la mesa del altar hasta la mesa del hogar. En mi charla en particular vamos a estar hablando un poco de cómo como mujeres podemos tomar esa corresponsabilidad de nuestro bautismo para traer, imponer en vivo la cultura eucarística en nuestras parroquias y en la comunidad de la gente con la que vivimos nuestra fe cada domingo. Así que amigos, espero que no se lo pierdan, los quiero ver allá. Que estén muy bien, nos vemos pronto.
Catherine es una de las tres presentadoras que va a estar aquí el próximo sábado, que vamos a tener la conferencia de mujeres. Solamente quiero hacer esta aclaración, la conferencia de mujeres en español no es algo que
alguien está haciendo o que viene de otro lugar. Es algo que nosotros en San José estamos haciendo. Y cuando digo nosotros, es Lupe y su equipo, ¿verdad? Así que es el equipo de la parroquia. Así que no es como que alguien más va a venir, sino es algo que nosotros estamos haciendo aquí en la parroquia. Si no han comprado su boleto, lo pueden comprar ya mismo. Debe ser abierta la oficina para que puedan comprar sus boletos o compren para alguna amiga que ustedes tengan y que se interese en venir la próxima semana, empezando a las 7:30. I said all this in Spanish because the conference is in Spanish. And so maybe one day soon we'll have a conference in English, a conference for women in English. But this coming weekend, this coming Saturday, is going to be all in Spanish. We also want to congratulate those who are celebrating your wedding anniversaries in the month of April. Do we have any April anniversaries? No April anniversaries? Okay, aquí hay unos. Un aplauso. You're the only ones. That's great. Fabulous. Y también queremos darle la bienvenida a los que están visitando. If you're visiting today, sponsors and everyone else that is not from San Jose, please stand. Okay, let's give him a big hand. That's great. Fabulous. Thank you very much. Thank you. Please remain standing because you're going to get a small gift from us, those who are visiting. I said gift and then everybody stands, right? Okay, that's great. That's the way we like it. And while you receive your gifts, I would like to say that last week we had a contest with those every kid that participated in the Rice Bowl for this year. We have a first place. These are the Rice Bowl boxes that got the most votes. We had a third place on the left, a second place on the right, and a first place at the center. Tomorrow, at what mass we're going to be giving the gift? At 8:00? At the 8:00 mass, we're going to be giving a prize to each of those three main winners. Let's give them all a big hand to everybody who participated. Very nice. And last but never least, we want to bless religious items. If you have some religious item that you would like to have blessed, please stand with your things in your hands. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name, O Lord. You are the fountain, source of every blessing, and you look with delight upon the devout practices of your children. Draw near, we pray, on these your servants, and as they use these symbols of their faith and devotion, grant that they may also strive to be transformed into the likeness of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Okay, nos vemos la próxima semana en la conferencia. We'll see you at the conference next week. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia. You're not singing. Teenagers are not singing. I know who is singing. You have a blessed weekend and a happy Easter. Regina Celi, laetare, alleluia. Quia quem eruis portare, alleluia. Resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia.
ora pro nobis Deum. Alleluia.
May the souls of our faithfully departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.